Welcome back to the final part of this demo series where we're going to clean up our account and return it to the same state as it was at the start of the demo series. So the first thing we need to do is to go back to the client VPN console, click on the Target Network Associations tab, select the association, and then click on Disassociate and confirm that disassociation. This will remove the interface within the VPC. You'll need to wait for that to complete, so at the moment it says disassociating, so we need to refresh it a few times. Now in my case it's taking longer than a few moments, so I'm going to pause the video and resume it once we're good to continue. You should do the same. Once that association's been removed, then you can go ahead and click on Actions at the top and delete the client VPN endpoint and follow up by confirming that deletion. Once that's finished, we need to go back to Certificate Manager, select the server certificate which we created earlier, click on Delete, and then confirm that deletion. Once that's gone, we need to go back to the Directory Service Console, click on Directories to move back to this level of the console, select the directory service, click on Actions, and then delete directory. You'll need to copy and paste the directory DNS name into the box, and then click on Delete. Now that will take some time to delete. It starts off in a deleting state, and we need this to finish deleting entirely before we can move on to the next step. So go ahead and pause the video and resume it once your directory service completes the deletion process. Okay, and once that directory is removed from this list, then we go to complete the final step. So go back to the CloudFormation console, go to Stacks, check the box next to A4L, click on Delete, and then confirm by deleting that stack. And that will delete all of the infrastructure created within this demo lesson and return your account into the same state as it was at the start of the demo. Now, if you want to, you should remove the client VPN application from your local machine, or you can leave it in place for any future experimentation or usage. Now, I hope you've enjoyed this demo series. You've implemented this architecture, and this has been a fairly simple implementation of the client VPN product, but the same steps will be used for large enterprise implementations. Now at this point, that's everything that I wanted you to cover. Go ahead and complete this video, and when you're ready, I hope you will join me in another exciting demo series.